Uganda is indeed the pearl of Africa. Now watch out for our I Love Uganda episodes every night in our news bulletin as we showcase our country. Let's head over to Nansana, where the Constitutional Court has dismissed with costs an election petition that was filed against the Nansana Member of Parliament, Parliament Robert Kasule Sebunya, on grounds that it was filed as a disguised appeal. The judgment has been delivered by the Constitutional Court Registrar Susan Nakanyinga.
The judgment arises from a petition filed by 8 political agents and supporters of the then Democratic Party candidate Wakaima Musoke Nsereko, led by National Action for Awakening Uganda, which is owned by Kampala businessman Frank Gashumba. Others are Margaret Namiro, Rita Nalunkuma, Annette Nachiungi, Fred Mugerwa Luanga, John Nakabale, Kuraish Ntale Kalema, and Isaac Sali. The facts of the case are that after the 2016 general elections, the National Resistance Movement candidate Robert Kasule Sebunya filed a petition in the High Court against the Electoral Commission challenging the election of Wakaima. This was on grounds that Wakaima was illegally nominated as a candidate and yet he was reportedly not a registered voter in Nansana and also lacked the required academic qualifications. As a result, the High Court Judge Vincent Okwanga found that Wakaima was indeed not a registered voter and lacked academic qualifications. Justice Okwanga accordingly declared that Sebunya, who had scored the second highest votes, was validly elected Member of Parliament for Nansana Municipality. In the said election, Wakaima obtained 25,053 votes. Following Justice Okwanga's decision, Wakaima appealed to the Court of Appeal, which heard and determined the appeal by dismissing it, thereby upholding the September 15, 2017 judgment by the High Court. But the said political agents and supporters of Wakaima in 2018 filed a constitutional petition in which, among others, argued that the judgment of the Court of Appeal was unconstitutional, which lacked the mandate of the people. This was under article of the Constitution and other enabling laws that give people the right to decide on who is supposed to lead them. As such, they asked court to nullify Section 63 of the Parliamentary Elections Act, which gives the High Court powers to take over the declaration, getting an appointing of representatives of Parliament as an arm of government after a petition has been decided. But the respondents during the hearing, through their lawyers Sekana Associates Advocates and consultants who represented Sebunya, argued that the case lacked merit as the law provides that all election petitions end at the Court of Appeal. They added that the petitioners had petitioned the Constitutional Court as an appeal, disguising it as a petition. However, in their judgment, the panel of 5 Constitutional Court justices, led by the Deputy Chief Justice Richard Butera, have agreed with the respondents and dismissed the case on grounds that it was a disguised appeal and that there was nothing constitutional for them to interpret.
We find that this petition is a disguised appeal. The petitioners are simply asking this court to sit on an appeal against a decision of the Court of Appeal in an election petition. The issues the petitioners have raised are matters that were heard and resolved by the Court of Appeal in the election petition appeal. They are not issues for constitutional interpretation of this court.
Other justices are Kenneth Kakuru, Christopher Izama Madrama, Catherine Bamgemerere, and Irene Esther Muliagonja. They said the Court of Appeal delivered a judgment and that the act of delivering a judgment cannot be inconsistent with the Constitution. In the judgment read by the Court Registrar Susan Kanyange on behalf of the justices, the petitioners have been condemned to pay costs to the respondents on grounds that the matter lacked merit and was causing annoyance.
The petition having been a disguised appeal lacks merit, cannot have been brought in public interest. It was frivolous and vicious. We are holding order that the petitioners pay costs to the respondents.
Speaking to journalists after the court's decision, lawyer Stephen Kalali, who was representing Sebunya, said he will talk to his client to draft a bill of course.
The supporters of Honorable Wakaima Musoke, together with Mr. Frank Gashumba, they have been directed to pay us costs. So we shall be engaging our client and we apply for those costs to be paid with immediate effect.
This is unbelievable. Now, if the judges are starting to treat Ugandans the way how we are being treated, Where are we going to now? The way I see things in Uganda, Ugandans will resort to not going to court because we go to court to expect fairness. But we don't see this. We don't see this. And the worst part of it, they are saying they are awarding costs. We never pleaded for costs because this is a public interest call, whatever matter. You're telling me, you're getting me. Now, we are going to consult our lawyers. I think we have to appeal to the Supreme Court.
This story was compiled by Annette Nakaibale for the news in Kampala.